washing gold. As we play, through the demon's eyes, as you scream, just before you die. Hello. Right. This time, more of the same, but I'm going to split it up. So this video will be me just drawing. I don't think I've shown much of me drawing, maybe some speeded up stuff, but this will be a little bit more in detail. And I haven't started yet, so you're going to see it from the end to when it's ready to be painted, which will be hopefully in a week or two, a couple of weeks. But yes, it's the usual scenario. I've done my thumbnail, photographed it, blew it up, printed it, and I'm going to transpose the shapes I like from this and the information I like from this onto here, and then basically work it up. And you'll see the stages that I go through. These stages are pretty much the same for most of the stuff I do, whether it's oil painting or working on a computer, because I usually start traditionally scan and go on the computer. Anyway, this is my usual process. And I'm going to be starting with a blue pencil. Hopefully you'll be able to see it on the camera. Sandy assures me you will. But with this, I start with this pencil because a dark line is almost like a full stop. It's like, it's there, so I'd start very lightly so I can still work into it and change stuff without fretting too much. And it's just the way I trained myself over the years to do it, so that's probably the main reason. But another goblin. This is my chance to do goblins, and I like goblins. So, and speaking of goblins, this goblin, this little fluffy wicker, is going down. Okay, so as I've said, and as I've done in the past, I'm just going to be transferring these main shapes over here, keeping it light to start with. And I've folded the paper and given myself a little sort of simple grid to help. Very loose, well, not so much loose, but big shapes to start with. That noise is a very demanding chihuahua. So yeah, the biggest shape obviously with a goblin is always the hat. They love their big hats. Mine do anyway. She really is being a very naughty chihuahua today. Very faint lines, as you can see, or can't see. Yes, in case I want to change any of the shapes at this stage, it's easier to
Obviously, it's easier to remove them when they're light lines rather than heavier lines. Try not to get distracted with detail too early. It's very easy to fall in that trap. This is fine, just getting the proportions in still. Okay, so as you can just about see, I've got the main shapes in, the big shapes. The shape, the silhouette, and a few of the medium shapes as well. So now, reasonably happy with that, so I'm going to go back and work in some of the more the slightly smaller shapes, start picking out certain details. And also neatening up some of these lines and making a few adjustments as I go along. So as usual, I'm very happy with the thumbnail, and I'm sure I'll be more happy with the thumbnail than the finished thing, but we'll see. So, while I carry on picking out some more of these lines, see these lines are actually saying quite a lot in this thumbnail, so these are the ones I'm trying to pick up. Once I've done that, I'll be more comfortable drawing them in more properly and adding more details. So I'm going to put some music on now, and I'll see you in a few minutes.
Right, so that's as far as I'm going to go with the blue lines. I could go further, but it's a waste of time really, because I've got all the information I need. And so now it's to my trusty retractable pencil. Road train. Nicked this from Gaines Workshop years ago. Yep, anyway, so this is, anyone who's interested, 0.5 lead, and it's 2B, as far as I know. And I'm just going to be doing sort of crosshatch type method, rather than block shading or anything like that. But there might be a little bit of that, we'll see. Anyway. So, just picking out more details, and starting to suggest lighting and things like that as we go along. And I think I'll start from the bottom. Pretty straightforward stuff to start with, just following the blue lines I've made. Because I'm going to be painting over the top, I don't need to invest too much time in getting the dark areas or anything like that. Yeah, this is just a guide for the painting over the top, really. It'll still be fairly detailed though. So as I was saying, there's not really much to talk about here. I mean, you'll see what's happening just by watching me. But what I'm going to be doing is picking out the lines that I like, and bearing in mind that I'm going to be painting over the top, so not to overwork it too much. I'm basically using the crosshatch method. Yeah, so see you soon. Cheers.
So I'm coming into the home stretch now, I think. Started off with a blue pencil, worked in the detail.
I've actually done more detail than I normally would, purely for your entertainment. But it won't affect the painting, it will only help the painting.
I've tried to hold back on the face and the sort of flesh areas with the pencil because I don't want to get it too muddy during the painting phase, but everything else should work fine. It's pretty much the same technique I've been using in the past videos.
Right, I think that'll do for this stage. Thanks for watching again. I enjoyed that. As I said, put a bit more detail in just for your entertainment, really. But I think that'll work nicely. I've left the background sort of hazy, but I'm thinking of painting that as well, but we'll see. This will be up now as far as you're concerned, and the colour one, part two, will be in about a week or so. Maybe sooner. We'll see. So thanks again, and best of luck to everyone. Cheers.